Hello everyone, I'm Ashwit. I'm one of your fellow students at 6002X as well as a community TA. Okay, and I've seen a lot of questions on the forums related to signs and the associated variables discipline or the passive sign convention. Both are names for the same thing. And I thought I'd just spend some time trying to clarify some of those issues. Okay, and to do this, let me go back to a battery. Okay, so we know that a battery, a chemical cell, consists of an electrolyte in a container. And it consists of two electrodes. Okay, so it consists of a positive electrode. Okay, so this is positive electrode, and we know at the positive electrode we have anions, no, cations. Sorry, positive ions. It's cations. So let's call this A plus, where A can be any positive radical like CO2 plus. Okay, and on the negative side, we've got negative ions, and just to make it simple, let me consider electrons for now. Okay, alright, so what happens when we connect a resistor? So we have a resistor like this. Okay, when we connect a resistor, we know that electrons will flow from this side to this side. Okay, and why is that? That's because this electrode is at a lower potential compared to this electrode, and we know that electrons flow from lower potential to higher potential, which is the opposite behavior when you look at when you compare that with positive charges. So a positive charge will obviously move from positive higher potential to lower potential, right? But an electron has negative charge, so it moves from lower potential to the higher potential. Okay, so that's what electrons do. So now let's concentrate only on the resistor. Okay, and what I want to talk about is, because this was one source of confusion as well, okay, and suppose we have a current I going through this resistor. Can we have what we normally do is we assign this way. Okay, so I want to spend some time explaining why do we do this. Okay, we just saw that the electron moves from the negative potential to higher to the positive potential, right? From low potential to a higher potential, right? Suppose the electrons move. Suppose the current is in this direction. This IR is in this direction. We know that the electrons will move in this direction. Okay. Suppose we have an electron right over here. Okay. If the electron is moving in this direction, we need to have the condition that the potential over here, okay, is lower compared to the potential over here. Okay, and this is the reason why we put a positive sign here and a negative sign here. Okay. And this actually leads to the passive sign convention. I'll actually tend to use the word use the term passive sign convention because that's what I'm used to, and you also see that in some other books as well. And what I also mean is the associated variables discipline. Okay, so let's get back to the resistor. So now you understand why the current is in this direction when the voltage is and the voltage is taken in that sense, right? Okay, so what does this give us? We know from physics that a resistor will always dissipate power. It'll never supply power. Okay, that's not the property of a resistor. Okay, let's calculate the power across this resistor. I can even throw in some numbers. So this is 6. Let's consider this as 6 volts. Okay, and let this current be 2 amps. Okay, which will mean that this is a 3 ohm resistor. Okay, so when we calculate the power, what do? We take power, okay, is equal to the voltage across the resistor times the current through it, right? So let's be consistent with our notation here. Okay, and what do we do now? We just throw in the numbers, right? So we say 6 into 2, and that is 12 watts, right? So that's the power. Notice that this is a positive number. Okay, and we also note that this power is actually dissipated power, right? Dissipated power. Okay, I hope my spellings are right there. Okay, so this power is dissipated, and we notice that it's positive. Okay, so and this is positive, right? Okay, so what am I trying to say here? If we followed this convention, okay, I mean rather because we followed this convention for a resistor, we calculated the power dissipated, and it turned out to be positive, right? So to make things simple, or rather consistent, we follow the same convention for every device we see. Okay, and suppose we define the polarity like this. By convention, we always say that the current flows into this terminal, and that makes sense because I just told you how electrons flow in this direction, right? So that makes sense. Okay, so and this leads us to the conclusion that if the voltage across a component is in this sense, and we define the current in this direction, okay, if we then calculate the power, all we have to do is we have to take that voltage multiplied by the current, right? We don't need to put any signs over here. We don't have to put any negative signs, nothing. We can just dump in the numbers as they are. Okay, that leads to the passive sign convention. So what is the passive sign convention or the associated variables discipline? So all it says is we have a component. Okay, we have a simple component like this. Okay, that's supposed to be a rectangle. Okay, and this is the same figure you've seen in the lecture video as well. Okay, so suppose this is a device, let's say M. Okay, let's just call it a device M. Let's assign the voltage going this way. So V sub M is equal is this way. Okay, and this is the current I sub M. Okay, what did we just do? We just followed the same convention we did before. Okay, we had before. So we defined, I defined the voltage in this sense and I defined the current in this sense, right? Then the power PM, okay, will be equal to VM times IM. Notice I didn't have to put any sign in front, I just had to put them as they are. Okay, suppose instead we did our notation in this sense, right? So suppose I did VM prime with the positive terminal here and the negative side here. Okay, then again I would follow the convention and say that IM prime would be in this direction, right? Now if I did this, PM prime would be equal to VM prime times IM prime, right? Okay, now the device is still the same, so the power needs to be the same. Is it the same? It obviously is, because we know that this VM, okay, is in a sense opposite to this VM prime, okay? So this is nothing but equal to negative VM, right? Similarly, this current IM prime is in opposite sense when you compare it with the IM we first looked at. So this is nothing but negative IM, okay? And we end up getting the same VM times IM, okay? So notice, if we follow the convention judiciously or faithfully, we end up always having a positive sign in front of our power formula. Okay, so that's the reason why we use the passive sign convention. So the passive sign convention says that if you have a voltage defined across a device and you define the current going into the positive terminal, then the power dissipated. Okay, and the key point is the power dissipated. Okay, you need to underline the word dissipated in your head. Okay, the power dissipated is positive. Okay, so I'm calculating the power dissipated over here. Okay, now let's apply this to the circuit on the left hand side. Okay, and I hope to address some issues you had over there as well. Okay, so we have a simple voltage source connected to a battery, and this is the same circuit you've seen in one of the exercises. And let's again assume that this is 6 volts, just to keep the numbers simple. And this time let me take that this as 2 ohms. Okay, and we know that the current through this will be 3 amps. Okay, so this is what logic would tell us, right? And we even done this in physics. Okay, in simple physics, we know that the current goes from here. Okay, and I just showed you from the battery, the current moves in this direction and goes all the way like this. And we know that because we have a 6 volts source connected to this resistor, the voltage across this resistor VR, okay, will be also 6 volts. So we know that VR will be equal to 6 volts. Okay, now notice this current. This current is going in fact into the positive terminal of this resistance. Okay, so I sub R is equal to 3 amps, right? This implies that the power dissipated by the resistor is equal to 6 times 3, which is 18 watts, right? Okay, remember, this is dissipated power. Okay, this is like the key thing I'm trying to stress on. Okay, dissipated power. Okay, this is key. Okay, so let me just box that in. Okay, this is the power dissipated by the resistor. Now let's look at the voltage source. You see the voltage source, if I take the same I sub R, so this is I sub R. Okay, this is in violation of the passive sign convention. So what I do is I take another current. Okay, just for notation, remember there is no two currents flowing through this circuit. There is only one current. Okay, but just for notational convenience, I'm going to define another variable. Okay, current variable called I. Let's call it IV, because that's the current flowing into the voltage source. Okay, and we know, it's common sense that IV is equal to minus IR. So we know that IV is equal to minus IR. Okay, which is equal to minus 3 amps, okay? So you have 3 amps flowing in this direction, which is the same as saying that 3 amps is flowing in the opposite direction, okay? And that should make sense. I see that some of you had a question here as well. So the analogy I gave in the forums was, if I give you 5 gold coins, that's like me getting negative 5 gold coins, right? It's like having a deficit, right? So that's the same logic we use here. So if you're going, or you could probably say from physics, if you're traveling 3 meters per second in this direction, it can also mean that you're traveling negative 3 meters per second in this direction, right? So this is the same, it's the same vector, right? Of course, current is not a vector, but it's a similar reasoning over here, okay? So that's how I gave the sign to IV, okay? And I hope that clears one question that a lot of you had, okay? So what is IV? IV is nothing but minus 3 amps, okay? And what is the power dissipated by the voltage source? So the power dissipated by the voltage source, so let me call that P sub V, is equal to the V, okay, times IV, okay, and by this I mean multiplication, okay, and what do we have over here? We have 6 into minus 3, and we end up with minus 18 watts, okay. Now, again, remember, this is the power dissipated, okay, and if I just concentrate on the word dissipated for now, it makes no sense, right? So the resistor, it makes sense that the resistor dissipates power, but it does not make sense that the voltage source dissipates power. It's supposed to supply power. That's where the negative sign comes in, okay? So when you see the negative sign, that means negative power has been dissipated. Negative power being dissipated is exactly the same as positive power being supplied, okay? That's what the signs mean, and that's the question a lot of you had. So whenever you see power being negative, okay, is negative, okay, this implies power is actually being supplied by the component, okay? The negative sign is just used so that we always talk in terms of dissipated power, okay? That's the convention, that's the passive sign convention. So we always talk in terms of dissipated power, okay? So that's what negative power means, okay? So I hope that clears one more question. The last doubt a lot of you people had was related to the signs of the voltages and currents themselves, okay? So let me just clear this up and make things a little neat, okay? So we have six volts. We have, I think I had 2 ohms over here and I had 3 amps over here, okay? And this makes sense. So this is, so I'm going to change my variables a little bit. Let me call this V1, okay? Let me call this VR1, okay? So this is how it was before, minus. Let me call this I1. And let me call this I sub R1, okay? So that's the notation I've used. And this is exactly like we saw what we saw in the previous problem. So rather the previous example. So we know that V1 equals 6 volts. We know that I1 equals minus 3 amps or negative 3 amps. And then VR1 equals 6 volts and IR1 equals 3 amps, okay? And we know that the powers dissipated are 18 watts over here, and the power dissipated is negative 18 watts over here, okay? So that's important, okay? So now let me get in another circuit. It's the same circuit, but I want to just talk about the notation again. Here what I do is I define a voltage V2, okay? But I put the positive terminal here and the negative terminal here, but this is still the same 6 volt source, okay? It's the same 6 volt source, okay? And I have 2 ohms over here, 6 volts and 2 ohms, okay? And now what I do is I stick to the passive sign convention always, okay? So I define a current in this direction, okay? I define the current in this direction, all right? Similarly, I stick to the convention. So if you see a voltage in this sense, actually for the voltage, you can put any sign you want. So I could have actually defined VR2 in this direction as well, okay? So let's not do that for now, okay? Let's define VR2 in this sense, okay? I'm doing this so that V2 equals VR2, okay? So I'm just doing this to make it simple. Again, we stick to the passive sign convention and we say that the current goes in this direction. So this is IR2, okay? Now let's put the numbers in. What will V2 be equal to, okay? V2 will be equal to minus 6 volts. Why is that? Because it was 6 volts in this direction, right? This was 6 volts. This is 6 volts, Okay, if I'm flipping my sense, okay, if I'm flipping the sense of the voltage, okay, then that's the same as flipping the signs. Okay, it's the same analogy I gave you for vectors just now. Okay, so if this is 3 meters per second, this is the same as minus 3 meters per second in the opposite direction. Okay, so a voltage is in this sense, which is 6 volts, is a voltage of minus 6 volts in the opposite sense. Okay, that is V2. Okay, this also means that VR2 equals minus 6 volts. Okay, so far so good. Okay, what is IR2 equal to? We know that IR2 from Ohm's law. Okay, I'm applying Ohm's law over here. Okay, IR2 equals VR2 divided by R. Okay, I end up getting -3 amps, right? -3 amps. Now think about this for a minute. If I'm getting -3 amps flowing in this direction, it's the same as +3 amps flowing in this direction, right? Okay, and so you see that this result, okay, agrees with the result over here. Okay, it agrees with the result over here. Okay, so don't worry about the signs. That's what I'm trying to say. When you consider the signs as well as the direction you've indicated in your figure, okay, things will make sense. Okay, so the sign as such does not make sense. Okay, logically speaking, the current has to flow in this direction and go over here. But suppose you do take the arrow in this direction, you will end up with a negative answer. Okay, and if you end up with a negative answer, that means the actual direction of current is in the opposite direction you've taken, and everything then should make sense. Okay, so that's what I was trying to stress over here. Similarly, I2 will be equal to -IR2, okay, which will be equal to 3 amps. Okay, and this also makes sense because it's 3 amps in this direction. So in this direction it is 3 amps, okay, which we just solved from this calculation. We also know that it's 3 amps in this direction over here. So the circuit is the same and our numbers are the same. What about power? Okay, so power P2 equals the current through the resistor, through the positive terminal of the resistor, that's power dissipated. Again, remember, it's dissipated. The power dissipated is VR2 times IR2. Okay, and this is nothing but -6 times -3. Okay, which is equal to 18 watts. Okay, so you see we've got the same answer as before. So power dissipated is positive and it is 18 watts. Okay, similarly, PV2, okay, which is power dissipated by the resistor, will be equal to -6 times, the current this time is 3, which is -18 watts. Okay, so this shows that our as long as we stick to our convention and we are consistent with the convention, okay, this important thing is we have to be consistent with the convention, okay, our results come out perfectly fine. Okay, so let me just clear up everything and just review it quickly. Okay, so let me just paste that circuit again. So what I'm trying to say is, you, whenever you solve a problem, you pick any voltage direction you like. Okay, you can pick any voltage orientation you like. You can put V in this direction and, you know, VR in this direction. Okay, it doesn't matter at all. Of course, one of the directions is more convenient. It's more convenient to flip this direction. It makes more sense. Okay, and it's your numbers become easier as well. But you can put any convention you like. I mean, you can put any direction you like. However, whenever you talk about current, you have to make the current go into the positive side. Okay, into the positive side or positive terminal. Okay, so this is IV. You just, as long as you follow this convention, you won't go wrong in your calculations. You could also have followed an opposite convention where, you know, you talk about the power supplied instead of the power delivered. But then you'll not be, but that's not a standard convention. Of course, your results would be right. You're talking in terms of power supplied. Okay, but this convention, the associated variables discipline or the passive sign convention, follows the power delivered, always talks about the power delivered. Okay, and that's the essence of the passive sign convention. So the key thing is you always make sure the current goes into the positive terminal. If you do that, your numbers will always turn out right. Okay, so you'll always end up having P equal to VR times IR. Okay, and when you put in the numbers, you'll end up getting a positive number. And over here, P equals V into IV. Okay, and when you put in the numbers, you'll get a negative number. But over here, you don't have to put any sign for the formulas. Okay, and that's the passive sign convention. I hope this helped you out, and I'll stop here. Before, just like to add one more thing. Let's look at a little bit on the terminology. If you ever see someone talking about supplied power, Okay, and someone asking what is the supplied power. If you get a, if you're actually talking about a supplied power, then you use a positive number to to denote power that is actually supplied. Okay, and if you in your calculations you end up getting you get actually end up seeing that power was dissipated, then you use a negative number. Okay, so that's when you're talking about the supplied power, because you will actually see questions asking, okay, what is the power supplied by a particular device? Okay, so if the power is actually supplied and the question is asking you for supplied power, okay, if you're being asked for supplied power, then obviously you'd use a positive sign, right? Okay, and when somebody is asking about dissipated power, okay, then a positive number would mean that that power is actually dissipated. Okay, so and negative number would mean that power is actually supplied. And we saw the latter case in we saw this case in the passive sign convention, right? We saw this case in the passive sign convention, right? So when in the passive sign convention we only talk about dissipated power, okay, so in that case if we end up with a positive number, that means power is actually dissipated, okay, but if we get a negative number, it means that power is actually supplied. But suppose somebody asks you about supplied power, obviously the sign convention for power flips in that case. So I just wanted to add this small bit in case the main video confused you about the signs, because you will actually see cases where you're asked for supplied power, and if you put a if you actually have power supplied and you slap in a negative number there, you'll get the answer as wrong, right? So be careful with the terminology used. Okay, the passive sign convention uses this, but even if you use the even though you're supposed to use the passive sign convention, the final result you may need to present may actually follow the convention which is up over here. Okay, so I just wanted to add that as well.